Hey, how's it going? So I wanted to make this video about attempting to live up to someone else's ideal. Someone else's ideal of what it means to be a spiritual master, what it means to be a meditator, what it means to be on the spiritual path. Attempting to live up to someone else's idea of what it means to be on the spiritual journey. Live by your own expectations. And what I also want to say about that is sometimes we can set ourselves an ideal that we sometimes fail to live up to and go through this drama of guilt of not quite measuring up to even our own ideal. So, being aware of that also is key. Now, that's not to say that other people encouraging you to expand is a bad thing. I watch a lot of videos of, I guess you could call them gurus, and although I don't really resonate with surrendering completely to a guru, I do enjoy being stretched. But when I'm being stretched, and what I'm talking about is holding myself to a higher set of standards, holding myself to a higher set of standard, waking up at a decent time, hydrating myself, doing exercise, those kind of things. I find that exciting though. I find the challenge of that enjoyable. But when you're trying to run before you can walk, I guess, it can be really painful and you can sometimes even do yourself more harm than good. For example, if you're going from eating junk food straight jumping into 100% raw, that could potentially do you more damage than good. You could have the 100% raw as an aim, but take the steps that are necessary to get to that, rather than jumping ship without a life jacket and not being able to swim. So, as I've been saying in the past couple of videos, there's a lot of great information out there. There's a lot of great books, a lot of great concepts, ideas. But while you're taking in this information, just honestly ask yourself, is this really me? Is this the lifestyle that I want? Am I just doing it because he's telling me it's cool, or she's telling me that this is the next hot thing? This is what's cool right now. Honestly ask yourself, do I really want this? And when you can ask yourself that and go through that process, then I think you have more a sense of meaning. You kind of know deep down why you're doing it. So you're not doing it just because everyone else is doing it. Don't be afraid to walk your path. And that goes for the stuff that I'm saying as well. Just because I think that yoga is so cool and I think that Qigong is so cool, it doesn't mean that it's the path you're on. I believe that we all come into this world with different destinies, but it's up to us how we walk the path of our destiny. And I do believe right now, at this particular time in humanity, that we can rewrite our own destiny. And I guess that's a topic for another video when I've contemplated that. You see, I'm still a student, I'm still on this journey learning, and sometimes I finish making a video and I think, why have I said that? Because I've missed out a very important key point. So, when I was younger, I made some decisions and I kind of deprived myself of having certain experiences in relationships, trying to be a good spiritual man, when really I wish I'd just dived in and had experiences and learned from them, learned from my own mistakes rather than distancing myself from life. And that's something that you can do on this spiritual journey, is distancing yourself from life too much. And I mean, that may work for some people. I always mention balance, a balance between having your quiet time to be, but also engaging life right now. So, retreating to spend the rest of my days at the top of a mountain doesn't really resonate with me right now. Maybe that was for an earlier time. Or maybe, look, it's you are the path, so it's whatever is resonating with you and just follow that path. I'm a big believer in that. I hope you got something from this video. Take it easy. Peace.